Hey, we're finally back with more Daily Toast. I'm Sonic Toast, and we're a little bit behind because, yes, it's Mario Kart month, and I said we'd be doing a Mario Kart game every week leading up to the launch of the new Mario Kart 8 for the Wii U. And, of course, since we didn't Daily Toast last week, we're a little bit behind, so I figure we also haven't done a themed week this month either, so the theme of this week, the last week of the month, this theme is going to be kart racing games. We don't have enough Mario Kart games left to fill the whole week, so we'll just do other kart racing games anyway. But the first game we're going to do is Super Mario Kart! Yay! For the first week of our kart racing slash Mario Kart theme week. Yay, Toast, Rabbit, Tibbles. Okay, so what can we say about Super Mario Kart? Honestly, Super Mario Kart is one of those games that really pushed the limits of the Super Nintendo. It's one of those games that just took technology to the next level. This can be categorized with Star Fox and Donkey Kong Country as three of those revolutionary games on the Super Nintendo. Those three games just kind of, they were just spectacular, things we never saw before. What Mario Kart had to bring was a new system called Mode 7, right? Where it used the 2D graphics to simulate a 3D environment all around you. How did they even come up with this? I can tell you. What they did, what they were trying to do when they created Super Mario Kart, they were actually trying to make a sequel to F-Zero. Yes, F-Zero. Show me your moves, F-Zero, that one. They were trying to make a sequel and trying to use this new Mode 7 technology on F-Zero. But the thing about F-Zero is it's a very fast-paced game. It's like Rad Racer, if you played Rad Racer on the NES, right? So that's what F-Zero is. It's very, very fast-paced. But with this new kind of environment technology, they couldn't go that fast. And they couldn't have the sequel be slower than the original, right? So they said, okay, what are we going to do? Like, oh, we can make a slow racing game if we make it a cartoony kart racing game. So they put together this cartoony kart racing game, and as sort of a reference, sort of an homage to Mario, they put the characters, right now they're just generic blank characters, they put them in overalls, right? And then one of the developers kind of just had the idea, had the, you know, the picture of the character, he just drew Mario's head on top of this overalls wearing blank character, and suddenly, ding, it just clicked for everybody in development. They're like, oh, wow, that's perfect. So then all the weapons they developed, they changed them to be really Mario-esque weapons, turtle shells and banana peels and stars, and they brought back Donkey Kong Jr. to be in the roster, one, to justify the banana peels, and two, as sort of a way of making Mario Kart like a history of all of Mario, you know, starting from the beginning with Donkey Kong Jr., you know, one of his earlier enemies, and even, you know, Bowser, his current enemy, and everyone in between, Koopa Troopa, Yoshi, Luigi, Toad, Peach, just a nice little roster of eight. And Super Mario Kart turned out to be quite successful, as you probably know, looking at the Mario Kart series today. So, that's our Daily Toast for today. It's to Be sure to tune in tomorrow for another Daily Toast.